Hello friends, this is Durga from IT Varsity. At this time we are talking about learning SQL using Oracle, and as part of this video I will try to explain you filtering. Okay, so filtering, so as I have mentioned to you earlier, select and from clause are important. From is primarily used to specify the table names, and select is primarily used to specify derived columns or regular columns from the table. And we have seen both the scenarios, the derived columns as well as regular columns, as part of the last video. Now, continuing the same data set, let us define our first problem statement. The statement is get all the get full name and commission amount only for those employees who have commission percentage. Others I don't want to see. Okay, so here you can say select first name concatenated by space, that is the formula for full name, and then last name. First name space last name is the formula, and then here you can say commission percentage multiplied by salary, and we will give the column names. You can use as clause if you want to if you want to make it more readable, but that is not mandatory. You can ignore as clause also while giving the alias to the column name, and then it will give us commission amount. Then we have to say from employees. Now I just want to get a full name and commission amount for those employees who have commission percentage. Others should be filtered. Here you can use where clause, and commission percentage is null if commission percentage is not applicable. So when it comes to null, it's a special type. Null represent nothing. So that field does not have anything, and typically to compare whether to compare something with a value, we use equal to or greater than or equal to or less than or equal to, depending upon our requirement, or not equal to. But when it comes to null, as it is special type, we have to treat it in a special way. The greater than or equal to, less than or equal to are not valid for null. Okay, for null we just have to check whether a value exists or not. So it is null or is not null. So that is the syntax we need to use to check whether the commission percentage is there or not. Okay, if you say is null, it will try to get the commission amount as null value, because we are trying to compute commission amount for employee where commission percentage is null, hence commission amount will be null itself. Okay, we don't want to do that. We just want to get the commission amount for those commission percentage is not null. So you just have to say is not null. So sometimes we want to get the records where a particular field is null. In that case you can say is null. But for our problem statement, for this problem statement, I am interested only in those employees whose commission percentage is not null. That's why I have to use is not null. Okay, now you can see the commission amount for all those employees where commission percentage is defined. Now let us make it a little bit more interesting. For that, let us preview the data. So here I will preview only those employees where commission percentage is not null. Run. Okay, so you can see the data here. So commission percentage is decimal value. 0.4 represents 40%, 0.3 represents 30%. So on and so forth. 0.25 represents 25%, etc. So in this case, I just want to get the commission percentage or commission amount only if commission percentage is not null and also commission percentage is greater than 15%. For those commission percentage where commission percentage is less than 15%, I am not interested. Okay, so let's define the problem statement here. Who have commission percentage and also commission percentage greater than 15%. Okay. So you can pick this query and first let us see directly specifying commission percentage greater than 0.15 and see if it works. Yeah, it is working and we got data only if commission percentage is greater than 0.15%. We have only 24 records. Earlier we have more than 24 records. Okay. So total there are 35 records who have commission percentage and here we got only 24 where commission percentage is more than 15%. And now another problem statement. The problem statement is get full name and commission amount only for those employees who have commission percentage less than or equal to 15%. So commission percentage has to be less than or equal to 15%. And if it does not exist, return 0, okay, which means like something like 0%. I just want to get the commission amount as 0 if commission percentage is null. If it is less than or equal to 15%, I want to get the commission amount. Okay, so here we have to get all those records where commission percentage is null and compute commission amount as 0. And for those commission percentage exists, I just want to get commission amount. So here we need to mix the knowledge which we have attained as part of the last video and this new video as part of this effort. Okay, so here this does not change. We can actually take this one and we have to add a bit on top of it. So here I want to say commission percentage less than or equal to 15%. If I just run this query, what will happen? Only if commission percentage exists, we'll get the commission amount. See here, it only returned 11 records. But I have to get 107 minus 24, which is approximately 83. I need to get approximately 83 records. So this is not correct. I have to get commission, those employees where there is no commission percentage assigned to them. So here we have to use these additional operators called OR and Boolean OR and Boolean AND. Okay. So here I have to say OR commission percentage is null. If I run this now, what I will get? I will get null for all the employees where there is no commission percentage. And for those where there is commission percentage, I will just get the commission amount. But here I want to display 0. So what I am supposed to do, I have to use case when clause, case when commission percentage is null, than 0, else end. Okay, let me okay, that's how you can use KSPN class, and you can run the query. Now you see commission percentage is 0. For where there is no commission percentage assigned to a particular employee, and where there is commission percentage is less than or equal to 15%, we got the commission amount. Okay, so to make it a bit more complicated, we will define another problem statement. So we want to get full name and commission amount. That is the main thing. But if commission percentage is up to 10%. So here I want to give additional bonus to my employees. So if it is up to 10%, I want to give additional 2% to them. So whatever their salary is, I want to give additional 2% of their salary if commission percentage is up to 10%, or let's say 15%. Give additional 2% if commission percentage is between 16% or greater than 16% and less than or equal to 50%, give additional 1% if commission percentage is greater than 50%, no additional commission. If commission percentage is null, which means if commission percentage is not officially assigned, then I just want to give 5% of the commission. So this is the problem statement. Now we have to mix, we have to leverage the entire knowledge which we have gained so far. There is no filtering of the data, so we can remove the where clause. So we can work, we can copy, paste this query, okay, and we can improvise on it. So what if we are saying, if commission percentage is null, then I want to get salary multiplied by 0.5%, which will give us commission amount for those commission percentage is null. Then comes 10%, 15% condition, okay? Case when commission percentage is less than or equal to 0.15, then I want to get salary multiplied by commission percentage plus salary multiplied by 0.02. I have to give only 2%, so here I have to say 0.02. Okay, and then case when commission percentage greater than 15 and commission percentage less than or equal to 50%, 0.5, then I can copy this one. And here I just want to get give 1%. Else, if it is greater than 50%, I just have to say commission percentage multiplied by salary. Okay, and then we can actually run this query. So when you apply this case when conditions, it will start applying one condition at a time. First, it will check if the commission percentage is null. Then it will say salary multiplied by 0.5%. If it is not null, then it will go to the next one. If it is true, then it will not go to the next one. And one of the most common mistake people will do is if they overlap. So let's say you say less than or equal to 0.15 here, or 0.15%. And if you say greater than 10%, okay? And if you get a record with 12% as the commission percentage, even though the condition satisfies here and here, it will only execute this one. It will not go to the next case when clause. It is like if else. So even if you have overlap, whenever it satisfies the condition for the first time, it will try to use that and go to the next record. As if it is 12%, this one can be true, this one also can be true. But it will only apply this logic. It will not apply this one. Okay, and you have to be extremely careful when you use this complex transformations to make sure that you develop your case when logic properly with mutually exclusiveness in them. Otherwise, you might get into some inconsistent results. Now you can run this query. So there is a missing keyword here. Let me see. Case when commission percentage is null, then salary multiplied by 0.5. Okay. I don't need to say case every time. That is the problem. Case we have to tell only once. So probably this is the right way to actually develop the logic for readability purposes, and is for case, so we will keep end here. Okay, now we can actually select this query and run it, and you can see the results. It will return all 107 records. If you want to validate randomly, you can actually get salary and commission percentage also, along with our derived field commission amount based upon this complex logic, complex transformation logic. Okay, you can see, okay, this is not correct. We have to give only 5% of commission if commission percentage is null, so I have to use 0.05. Okay, so this is the complete query. Let me show you the query. So our problem statement is, let me zoom out a little bit. Yeah, our problem statement is, if commission percentage is up to 15%, give additional 2%. If it is between 16% and 50%, give additional 1%. If it is above 50%, give the original commission. If the commission percentage is completely null, I just want to give 5% of the commission. Hence, we have to use 0.05 for null. If it is less than or equal to 15, we give the regular commission, and we have to add additional 2% to it. And here you need to apply BODMAS rule, otherwise it can give incorrect results. Let us see if it works. But whether it works or not, it is always better to apply the BODMAS rule whenever you perform that multiple arithmetic operations as part of one expression. Okay, so as commission percentage is null, 1200 is the commission amount. So it is working as expected. For the null scenario, we are giving 5% commission. for the not null scenario, as it is 30%, so 13,500 into 30% is 0.3 equal to 4050. Plus, I want to give 2% extra. So 13,500. Sorry, 1% into 0.01 equal to 135. Okay, so 4050 into 135 is 4185. So it is working as expected, but still it is always better to use the board mass rules. So we want to multiply the salary with commission percentage, and then salary with additional 2%, and then we want to add. So the board mass, as per the board mass rule, multiplication will happen first. So whether you put these brackets or not, it doesn't matter. But in some cases where you add, subtract, multiply, division in multiple times, you might have to execute in a proper order in the nested bracket, and then you have to execute at the higher level. Hence, having the knowledge of board mass and applying the board mass is very, very important. Okay. And also, as I have done, you should test all different scenarios. For example, there are three unique scenarios here. One is when the commission percentage is null, salary should be multiplied with 5% of it to get the commission amount. Earlier, by accidentally, I did with 50%, not 5%. And because I tested the scenario, I figured out the problem and I fixed it. And then these two fall under similar scenario. So board mass rule and all are taken care. So you can pick without any issues. And if commission percentage is more than 50%, 50% or more, there is no data set here. So we will not be able to validate that scenario, but it is better if there is such record. So let me, instead of checking up to 50% here, let me do it for the 30%. If it is more than 30%, I don't want to, or 25%. If it is more than 25%, I don't want to give additional commission. Okay, up to 15% additional 2%, up to 25% from 16% additional 1%. Above 25%, I don't want to give any commission. I don't want to give any additional commission. So let me validate that scenario also, and then we'll wrap up. So here you can see, with 30%, there is no additional bonus. So it is working as expected. So this is how you can actually filter the data and also use case more effectively to implement a bit more complex transformations. That's why I have been emphasizing that you should focus on case as much as possible. That being said, we'll continue working on these transformations, filtering, and then we'll also talk about group by having joins, etc. And while we pursue that, we will also explore other transformations that we typically do as part of the select class. It could be row-level transformation, it could be aggregation, it could be analytic or windowing functions also, like for ranking, etc. That being said, thank you. Bye.